Today we will learn about the settings of the MeshBaker component. Every component in the MeshBaker package has an instructions drop-down with a step-by-step user guide. Hovering over any setting will also display a tooltip. The TextureBake result field lets the MeshBaker component use atlases created by a TextureBaker. You can leave this blank when combining meshes, but the combined mesh will use all source object materials instead of a single material. To learn how to make different source meshes share a single material, check out our TextureBaker tutorial. The first step when using a MeshBaker component is selecting the source objects you want to combine. MeshBaker includes tools for intelligently selecting groups of objects in a scene. These tools are covered in depth in a separate tutorial. If you only have a few objects, you can just drag and drop. MeshBaker will automatically grab the children of any objects you drag in. The Sort Along Axis button sorts objects to combine along the specified axis. This is useful when working with transparent materials, which often require you to render triangles from farthest to nearest. There are three different output options. Bake into Scene object generates a combined mesh which is an instance in the scene, not an asset in the project, so it can't be used as a prefab in other scenes. Bake into Prefab saves the mesh as an asset in the project and generates a prefab. This allows you to reuse the combined mesh in other scenes. Baking in Place is used by the Batch Prefab Baker to keep your meshes separate while sharing a material. This is covered in the Batch Prefab Baker tutorial video. Parent Scene object is a game object in the scene. The combined mesh will be a child of this object. The Mesh field is the combined mesh, which is either an instance or an asset. If you plan to reuse the same MeshBaker component for different sets of source objects, you should always reset this field to none before each bake. Otherwise, the previous mesh result will be overwritten. The Use Shared Settings field lets multiple bakers share the same settings. You can leave it blank, or assign a MeshBaker grouper or a MeshBaker settings project asset. If the Use Shared Settings field is left blank, then the settings below in the inspector are used. To create a MeshBaker settings asset, right-click in the project folder, go to Create, MeshBaker, MeshBaker Settings. Drag this asset into the Use Shared Settings field in the MeshBaker inspector. Now these settings can be reused in many different scenes. The checkboxes in MeshBaker settings allow you to select which mesh channels will be copied from your source meshes into the combined mesh. If a channel is missing from a source mesh, such as normals or tangents, MeshBaker will generate channel data. Light mapping UVs setting affects how MeshBaker handles the UV2 channel. This channel has some unique options. If you want to light map the combined mesh, we suggest using either Generate New UV2 Layout or Copy UV2 Unchanged to Separate Rects. Check out our light mapping tutorial for more information. If you're not light mapping the combined mesh, you can ignore UV2 or copy UV2 Unchanged. The Renderer setting lets you select which type of renderer you want your combined mesh to use. The regular mesh renderer is ideal for static geometry in your scene, while switching to a skinned mesh will allow your combined objects to still move independently after baking. Clear buffers after bake should be checked unless you intend to update a combined mesh by adding or removing objects. Normally this is only needed if you're baking at runtime. If it's unchecked, then MeshBaker will keep an extra copy of the mesh data internally for fast updates. However, this can use a significant amount of memory. Pivot location type changes the position of the combined mesh pivot. This can be set to the world origin, bound center, or to a custom location. The Optimize After Bake setting does the same thing as Optimize Mesh in the Model Importer Inspector. It optimizes vertex and triangle order for GPU performance. Large meshes can be slow to optimize, so it's a good idea to leave this off for runtime baking. The remaining two settings are related to skinned mesh renderers and texture arrays, which are each covered in their own tutorial video. Links to all the tutorial videos I've mentioned can be found in the description of this video. MeshBaker is available on the Unity Asset Store. Visit us at digitalopus.ca where you can find more resources and tips for using MeshBaker.